A rectangular field needs to be enclosed. Fencing costs $4 per foot for two opposite sides and $5 per foot for the other two sides. We want to find the dimensions of the field with an area of 800 square feet that will minimize the cost. Let's sketch a model for this situation. First, we know we have a rectangle and therefore the opposite sides are the same length. Let's let these two sides equal x feet. Let these two sides equal y feet. We know the area of this field must be 800 square feet. The area of this rectangle would be x times y, which again must equal 800 square feet. So our constraint for this problem is x times y, or xy, must equal 800 square feet. Again, this is often called the constraint. Now let's talk about the cost. Now let's consider the cost of the fence. It says it costs $4 per foot for two opposite sides and $5 per foot for the other two sides. This often occurs if they factor in the cost of gates for two sides of the enclosure. So it doesn't matter how we label this. Let's go ahead and just assume that the shorter sides here cost $5 per foot and the longer sides cost $4 per foot. Now let's write a cost equation. The total cost of the enclosure is going to be equal to the cost per foot times the number of feet. So if we first consider the cost of these two sides, the cost of this fence here is going to be x feet times $5 per foot, which would just be x times 5, or 5x. The opposite side is going to cost the same, 5x. Then the remaining two sides, or these two sides here, are going to cost $4 per foot. So the cost of one length here is going to be y feet times $4 per foot, which would just be 4y for this length, and then also 4y for this length here. So we have plus 4y plus 4y. So our cost function is going to be equal to 10x plus 8y. Now this is the equation that we want to minimize, but right now we have the cost function in terms of both x and y. We want to be able to rewrite this in terms of one variable using a substitution from the constraint. Again, we want to minimize this. This is often called the primary equation. So we're going to go back up to the constraint now and solve it for x or y. Let's go ahead and solve this for y by dividing both sides by x. So we would have y equals 800 divided by x, which means now we can replace this y here with 800 divided by x, and then we'll have the cost function in terms of one variable. So we'll have the cost equals 10x plus 8 times 800 divided by x. And now in order to minimize this, we want to first find the critical numbers by finding the derivative of this function and then determining where it's equal to 0 or where it's undefined. Before we do that, let's go ahead and rewrite this as c equals 10x. This is like 8 over 1. So this would be 6,400 over x, or plus 6,400 x to the power of negative 1. If we were to move this x up into the numerator, remember it's going to change the sign of the exponent. Now let's go ahead and find the derivative of this. So c prime is going to be equal to the derivative of 10x is 10. Here we'll apply the power rule, so we'll multiply by negative 1. So we'll have minus 6,400, then x to the power of negative 1 minus 1, which would be x to the power of negative 2. Which if we wanted to, we could write this as c prime equals 10 minus 6,400 all over x squared. So this would be undefined when x is equal to 0, but if x is equal to 0, the area of this rectangle would be 0, and therefore we're not going to consider that as a critical number. So now we're going to set this equal to 0 and solve for x. Let's go ahead and do that on the next slide. So if we set this equal to 0, let's go ahead and add this fraction to the other side of the equation, and we'll write 10 as 10 over 1. So we'd have 10 over 1 equals 6,400 divided by x squared. And now that we have two fractions equal to each other, this is a proportion, so we can cross multiply and then solve for x. So 10x squared must equal 6,400. Go and divide both sides by 10. So we have x squared equals 640. And now we'll square root both sides of the equation. Remember, we only have to consider the principal square root, or the positive square root, since remember x represents a length. And we want to round this to the nearest tenth, so x is approximately 25.3 feet. Now we need to keep in mind that we are trying to minimize the cost, and we only had one critical number to consider, and we often assume this is going to minimize the cost function. But remember, there are a couple of ways to make sure that at this x value, the cost would be minimized rather than maximized. One way is to check the sign of the second derivative at this x value. So let's go ahead and take a moment and do that. So here was our first derivative, which we'll go ahead and rewrite as 10 minus 6,400 x to the negative 2, and we'll find the second derivative, again, just to assure that at that x value we do have a minimum cost. Well, the derivative of 10 would be 0. Applying the power rule here, we would multiply by negative 2. It's going to be positive 12,800 x to the negative 3, which we can now write as 12,800 divided by x to the third. So at C double prime of approximately 25.3, notice how we would have 12,800 divided by 25.3 cubed. We only care about the sign here, so this is going to be positive or greater than 0. Remember, that tells us the concavity of the cost function. If the second derivative is positive, that means the function would be concave up. And therefore, at the critical number, 25.3, here, we would have a minimum function value. This just assures us that at x equals 25.3, we have minimized the cost. But remember, going back to our original sketch, we still have to determine the value of y. And we can do that here, since we know that y is equal to 800 divided by x. So if we substitute 25.3 for x, we would have 800 divided by 25.3. We'd have y is approximately equal to this quotient, which comes out to approximately 31.6 feet. So again, now we know that x is approximately 25.3 feet, and y is approximately 31.6 feet. If we take a look at our sketch, notice how we have less feet at the cost of $5 per foot, and we have more feet at the $4 per foot cost. So let's go ahead and summarize all of this. The first question was find the dimensions of the field with an area of 800 that will minimize the cost. Well, the dimensions of the field are x feet by y feet, or 25.3 feet. by 31.6 feet. Now it doesn't ask, but let's go ahead and find what that total cost would be. Remember, our cost function was equal to 10x plus 8y. So we'd have 10 times 25.3 plus 8 times 31.6. which comes out to $505.80. Okay, that's going to do it for this problem. I hope you found this helpful.